breath. Yesterday, we got into a lot of hamstrings, so I'm going to be a little nicer. So we'll get into a lot of hips instead. Blocks, maybe if you want them, or whatever you use as a block if you don't have them. Books are great. You know, a nice high stack of books. You want to place them on either end of the mat, and then whenever you're ready, we will get started. Child's pose. Back of the mat. Take those knees as wide as you like. Maybe even as wide as the mat if that feels good. Big toes are touching. Extend the fingertips forward. Forward to the mat. Just immediately notice any strain that you're starting to feel in the body. You might feel that dull, achy sensation there into those hip flexors. It feels really good as you reach those fingertips forward. You'll feel that stretch through those muscles on either side of the vertebrae, especially through the low back. With those eyes closed, just really tune into how your body feels. Tune into your breath. Start to actively slow it down. Focus more on those exhales. You'll notice as you focus on that slow breath, the body will start to respond. The hips sink a little bit deeper towards the heels. Those forearms, arms start to melt into the mat a little bit more. Elbows. Small muscles in the face start to soften. You'll notice the mind begins to quiet. It's that feeling you have right here, right now. I'm trying to maintain for the next 60 minutes. So although we will be in motion, asana to asana, posture to posture, I'm just trying to maintain that moving meditation, that feeling, that sense of calm, that sense of ease, sense of groundfulness. Take three full cleansing breaths, a nice deep full inhale through the nose, fill the lungs all the way up. As you exhale, open mouth, let it go. Take another nice deep full inhale through the nose. Fill the lungs up. Exhale, open mouth, let it go. Take one more just like that. Full inhale through the nose. Fill the lungs all the way up. Really fill them up and sigh it all out. Let's seal the lips. As you move into your Ujjayi breath, that's inhale through the nose, exhale through the nose. Breath is deep. Measured, it's even. So as soon as you lose the breath, it's an indicator you have gone too far. Pull it back. You'll always find yourself in any resting posture, whether that be back here in Child's Pose, Down Dog, Savasana, even standing tall in Mountain Pose. Never being shy about it, just take the break. Take a moment here, set an intention. You'll be sending out some good energy, some love to those that need it the most in these strange, stressful times. Just take a moment here and meditate on that deeply. This time, this space, this practice is for you and only you. Let it all go here. Allow the breath. Allow the body to feel good. Take another nice deep full inhale. Much longer, slower exhale. Really affirm the palms into the mat. Start to lift the gaze. Slide the torso all the way forward as those toes start to lift. Press the earth, make the palms drop back. Tuck the shin in, round it back, Child's Pose. As you inhale, start to lift the gaze, slide that torso all the way through. As you lift the toes, press the earth, make the palms. Try to kiss the shoulder blades together. Tuck the chin in, round it back. Do this a few more times. Your breath, your movement, it doesn't matter how fast or how slow. As you come into this kind of king cobra, just notice that those shoulders aren't by the ears. You're pressing the earth away. Think about dropping the head so much those big toes will meet. As you round it into that Child's Pose, I'll let you round it back. Maybe you can take an extra breath there in Child's Pose if that feels good. one more round. We'll meet that king cobra. Press the earth away. Press those hips towards the mat. Take one more breath. Extend those legs up nice and long behind. It should be pretty wide, that helps with distance, if not wider. Walk those fingertips forward. Variation your seal pose. Press the palms into the mat. Going to straighten through the legs, belly is engaged. Relax the jaw. And start to walk the right arm underneath that left. And bring that right shoulder to the mat and then walk that left arm over. So you create a little space here for your chin, a little pillow. And just pause here and breathe. Should be an easeful stretch. Two more breaths. If you start to release, walk those left fingertips forward first, affirm that left palm to the mat, press yourself up, then bring that right arm up, find that seal pose. This time out with the left arm underneath the right. And you start to bring that left shoulder to the mat and start to walk the right arm over. Honor the differences here on each side. Go where it feels good. You can stay here. You can breathe here with ease. Maybe close the eyes. Walk those right fingertips forward, press through that palm as you press yourself up. Find that same seal pose. Keep those arms nice and engaged, belly is engaged. Take the gaze on the bridge of the nose. If you want those hands in towards the hips, big toes to touch, slide back child's pose. Take two big breaths in child's pose. Inhale, take the gaze forward. You're walking forward into a puppy pose. So puppy pose, the hips are on top of the knees, so the hips are off of the heels. You're extending those forearms forward. Hips are high, maybe place those palms together, those palms under the nape of the neck. If it feels good on the neck, chin comes to the mat. Otherwise, forehead to the mat. Even further forward, get a little deeper into those shoulders. It causes you more strength. Just release it a bit. Take one more breath. Release into a tabletop position. Set yourself up for a few rounds here, cat-cow pose. Shoulders on top of the wrists, hips underneath. As you inhale, take the gaze up towards the ceiling, press the earth with the palms. Exhale, tuck around the curl, chin tucks into the chest. Move into that cow spine, really extend belly towards the mat. And you round it into that cat spine, haul it up the belly. A few more rounds, your breath, your movement, any other movements that feel good. Find that neutral spine. Find that tabletop position. Tuck the toes, hips back and up. Downward facing dog. First down dog of your practice. Whatever movements, motions feel good. Pedal the feet out. Shake the head yes, no. And come high the ball mounds of those feet. Take deep bends into the knees if that feels good. Drop the heels to the left, to the right. And kind of tune into your inner compass. It feels good here. And find some stillness. Check in on that alignment. Spread the fingers nice and wide from the entire palm to the mat, especially that space between the thumb and the first finger. Do you press through the palms, you feel the stretch through the shoulders. And start to extend the heels towards the mat, even if they don't meet the mat. This is causing strain at the hamstrings, the low back. Just micro bend into the knees, but the hips stay nice and high. Now belly is engaged, breathe deeply here. Nice deep full inhales. Let go through the exhales. Come nice and high on the ball, now into the feet, take the gaze forward. Tiptoe yourself all the way forward. Rag doll, grab opposite elbows. Head hangs heavy, tuck the chin in. Nice deep generous bend here into the knees. Resting that belly on the thigh, will protect through the low back. And take a generous space side to side. Bring your hips to the mat or to the shins, lengthen through the spine, take the gaze forward, halfway lift. So you exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lengthen, halfway lift, lean forward, gaze forward. Make sure those feet are hips width distance. It is two fist width if you need to take a measure. Thumb index and middle fingers, you grab the big toes. Go Paddhanguttasana, big toe pose. See if you can start by pressing the thumbs and the big toes firmly into the mat. Inhale, engage the legs, lean forward. Exhale, start to pull yourself forward. Take the elbows wide if they're bending. Bring more weight forward onto the ball, now to the feet. So if you press the thumbs, the big toes into the mat, other eight toes are nice and light. You should be able to lift them off the mat. Focus less on straightening the legs, more on length through the spine. Take one more breath. And slowly release, halfway lift to lengthen. Exhale to fold. Lift all 10 toes up the mat, belly sucked in, root to rise, arms up overhead, reach up, stretch up. Arms down by the side, Tadasana Mountain Pose, close the eyes. Find some strong breath here. Nice deep full inhales. Deep long, slow exhales. Should feel a lot of strength here through your body. Should feel a lot of length through the spine. Gently open the eyes. Sweep the arms up overhead. Right hand, but grab the left wrist. Reach and stretch everything up and over to the right, pushing the hips to the left. Right shoulder comes more forward. Maybe start to lift the gaze. Feels pretty good, perfect place to stay. Want to go a little bit deeper, step the left foot to the right. But then immediately draw that left hip more forward. Keep the torso square, pushing the hips to the left. Draw yourself back through center. Switching sides, left hand grabs right wrist. Reach and stretch everything up and over to the left, pushing the hips to the right. Left shoulder forward. Maybe start to lift the gaze. Really breathe into that whole right side of the body. Stay here. And step that right foot to the left side. Right hip comes forward. Keep the torso square. Draw yourself back through center. Bring those feet hips width distance. Place the palms high on the glutes. Elbows are nice and close together. Think about pressing those elbow tips together. Inhale as you lengthen. Exhale, push the hips forward. Take the gaze up. Really straighten through the legs. Engage the legs. Engage the glutes. Belly is engaged. Push the hips forward. Lift through the chest higher. As you inhale, come back through center. Arms up. Reach up. Stretch up. Belly button to spine. Micro bend into the knees. Forward fold. Halfway lift, lengthen, lean forward, gaze forward. Palms to the mat, step back, I think. On that top of a push-up position. Nice strong alignment here. Hips and shoulders in the same line. Press the earth with the palms. Take the gaze a little bit more forward rather than back and down. Take a full inhale. Exhale, lower halfway down, chaturanga. Come onto the knees. Inhale, upward facing dog or high cobra. Either way, press the earth with the palms. Hips back and up. Downward facing dog. Three full breaths here in your down dog. Nice deep full inhales. And then let go on the exhale. Your next inhale, lift that right leg up. Take a bend into the knee, stack the hip. Add any additional movement to it that feels good. Into that hip joint, knee, ankle, toes. Let's make sure that shoulder, right shoulder is down towards the mat. Just focusing on that hip. Re-extend right leg long behind you, hip draws down towards the mat. Find that three-legged dog from the palms to the mat, taking full inhale. Exhale, step it all the way through. bring that left knee to the mat. Take a supported lunge here. Just start by getting that left leg as long as you can behind you. Nice lunge here into that right. Kind of bend and straighten into this leg. And bend back into that right leg. Sweep those arms out nice and wide. Really open up through the chest, open up through the shoulders. Take the gaze. Sweep them back down and around. Tuck the chin. Palms face each other as you reach them forward. Sweep those arms down and back. All the way up. Open up through the shoulders. Take the gaze up. Sweep them back down. And reach them forward. Tuck the chin. One more time. Sweep them all the way up. Really reach them up. Stretch them up. As you sweep them down and forward, tuck the chin in. Sweep them up. Find steeple mudra grip. Interlace all 10 fingers, releasing the index fingers, crossing the thumbs, bring the biceps behind the ears. Inhale to lengthen, exhale, stretch to arch the upper body back. Belly button to spine. Breathe deeply here. Release that grip, reach those arms forward, tuck the chin in. Yogi's choice, we find Skandasana, bend into that left leg, use the fingertips or not. Slide yourself towards that left leg. Right leg comes nice and long. Heel to the mat, toes reflex. One or both hands to heart center. Draw the shoulders down the back. You notice that you're rounding forward, you're shaking. Just bring those fingertips to the mat, maybe to the blocks. Find some deep breath here. Relax the jaw. Give yourself a smile. As you release, low lunge, twist to the back. That left leg is bent. Left arm reaches up, nice and high, the ball onto that back foot. Right hip up. Take a little deeper into that left leg. Twist a little more. Reach that left arm forward. Slide it all the way through center. Bring those feet with you, opposite elbows, a wide-legged ragdoll. Tuck the chin in, let it go. You take really deep, generous sways side to side. Yep, that feels good. Release what you have. Fingertips under the shoulders. Lengthen. Lean it forward. Gaze forward. Pivot yourself towards the right toes. Keep that left foot exactly how it is. Right toes come all the way forward. It's really like a warrior two base. Walk the hands to the left. Push the hips to the right. Tuck the chin. You'll notice that right knee is going to want to cave in towards the midline. Energetically bring that right knee out towards the pinky toe. Breathe deeply here, that dull, achy sensation into that right hip flexor. I feel a nice stretch, that inner thigh on that left leg. Take one more breath. Release, walk those hands back through center, bring that right foot, and step it back, and flow through your vinyasa. Then you can always get that vinyasa up. Just meet us in down dog. Take it supported with the knees to the mat, whatever feels good. Inhale that left leg up. Bend the knees, stack it. Nice big hip roll. Any additional movements that feel good into that hip joint. Knee, ankle, toes. Just notice that that left shoulder is not towards the ceiling. You want to square off that shoulder. Find that three-legged dog. Left hip rolls down towards the mat. Spread the earth away. Press the earth away, spread the fingers long, take a full inhale. As you exhale, step it all the way through. Find that supported lunge, that right knee comes to the mat. Just kind of bend and straighten here into that left leg. Getting that right leg nice and long behind you. Let's try to get into that fatty part there on top of the knee rather than right on the knee. And find that left leg bent, right leg nice and long behind you. Take it nice, the arms wide, reach up, stretch up. Sweep those arms back down. Sweep them forward, tuck the chin in, palms face each other. Reach them down and up, take them wide. Feel that stretch through the collarbones, through the shoulders. As you take them down and reach them forward, tuck it in. One more time as you reach them up. And reach it down, reach them forward. Sweep those arms up. Find that same steeple mudra grip. Goofy thumb down and thumb on top. Start by bringing the biceps behind the ears. Inhale to lengthen, exhale, arch the upper body back. Breathe. Release that grip, reach those arms forward. Tuck the chin in. And you can use the fingertips, you're not nice and slow. The slower you move, the more control. Find yourself Skandhasana. Bend into that right leg. Left leg is long, toes are flexed. One or both hands to heart center. Draw the shoulders down the back. Find a drishti, something unmoving. Essential to your stability here, take one more breath. As you pivot yourself towards the right, toes low, lunge twist, deep bend into that right leg. Right arm reaches up, take the gaze up, left hip high. Twist a little bit deeper. And then press the left palm into the mat, rather than dumping into that shoulder, one more breath. Reach that right arm forward. Sweep yourself through center, bring those feet with you, forward fold. Halfway lift to lengthen. And fold a little bit deeper, whatever works. Grab the outsides of the feet, the big toes. Need a little more weight forward onto the ball mounts of the feet. Allow the breath to flow freely. Release what you have. Fingertips under the shoulders, lengthen through the spine, lean forward, gaze forward. Pivot yourself towards the left toes, that right leg stays exactly how it is. So you're bringing those left toes forward as if you're going into warrior two. Walk the hands to the right, push the hips to the left, tuck the chin to the chest. Energetically getting that left knee out towards the pinky, breathe here, let go, relax the jaw. Another nice deep full inhale. Nice long, slow exhale. One more breath. Release, walk those fingertips towards the center. Frame that left foot. Step it back. Flow through your vinyasa. So meeting downward facing dog. Three full rich cycles of breath. Close the eyes. When you notice that breath, you notice the richness in the breath. You just have that nice deep breath. It's easy to just stay present here. Inhale, right leg lifts. Exhale, step it all the way through. Open yourself up to warrior two. So heel to heel, heel to arch alignment. It is a nice long stance that allows you to lunge fully into that right leg. Extend long through the outside of that left leg. Draw the shoulders down the back. Track the torso to the left, right, knee to the right. Draw those fingers wide. Take that gaze past that middle finger. As you're gripping through the front toes, maybe start to lift them off the mat. We'll feel that straight there through that bottom. Take a full inhale. Exhale, Skandhasana into that left leg. Nice deep bend, nice and slow. Right leg comes to the mat. Heel comes to the mat. Flex through the toes. Draw the shoulders down and back. Pivot yourself towards those left toes. Low lunge twist. You've been here before, you know where to go. Really reach, extend, left fingertips up towards the ceiling. Bring that right hip up a little bit higher. Find that strength through that right palm. Pivot to the outside of the right foot. Vashtasana side kick. No matter how many steps it takes you to get there, as long as you do, if you can be staggered or stacked, you can bring the right knee to the mat. Bring that left foot in front of the right thigh. Just bring the hips high. Left hip a little bit more forward. Hug everything here into the midline. Take a nice deep breath. Left knee comes in towards the chest. Pause, hold here. Mindfully step that left foot through. Slide yourself through center forward fold. Halfway lift to lengthen, lean forward, gaze forward. Left hand will reach for that right ankle. Reach and stretch right fingertips forward and twist. One more way forward on the ball mounds of the feet. Breathe. One more breath. Bring those fingertips under the shoulders, lengthen through the spine, lean forward. As you pivot yourself towards those right toes, stay on the bottom onto that back, but bend deep into that right leg. Lift the gaze. Straighten both of those legs forward, fold. Bend back into that right knee. Left knee stays off mat, lift the gaze. Straighten through both legs forward, fold. Take that bend in. Straighten through the legs, three breaths here, modified pyramid pose. Forehead to knee, forehead to shin, right hip back, left hip forward. And get the heel on top of the toes of that back foot. Take that bend back into that left leg, two breaths. Lift the gaze, really charge up that left leg. Bring those palms to the mat, step back, and flow through your vinyasa. Find yourself in down dog, find your breath. Inhale that left leg up. Step it all the way through. Open up, warrior two. Find that alignment. Find that strength into that left leg. Track the torso to the right, left knee to the left. Draw the shoulders down the back. Arms are nice and strong, nice and engaged. Maybe close the eyes. Notice that breath is a little more active. You just slow it down. Take a little bit deeper into that left leg, nice deep foot, inhale. Exhale, scale back and bend into that right leg. One of both hands to heart center. Left leg is nice and engaged, toes are flexed. Pivot yourself towards those right toes, low low twist. Right arm reaches up, take the gaze up, twist the upper body back. And from that left palm to the mat, pivot to the outside of that left foot. Vashisasana side plank. Bring those hips high. Flex through those toes. And bring that right knee towards the chest. Pause, hold here. Slowly, mindfully step that right foot forward. Draw yourself through center forward fold. Halfway lift to lengthen. That right hand will grab that left ankle. Extend those left fingertips forward, find a twist. We're warming forward onto the ball mounds of the feet as you twist a little bit deeper. Take one more breath. Please bring those fingertips under the shoulders, lengthen. Pivot yourself towards those left toes. Charge through that right leg. Knee stays off the mat. Take the gaze up. Straighten through both legs forward, forward. Bend back into that left leg, lift the gaze, really charge that right leg up. Straighten through both legs, forward fold. Bend back in, lift the gaze. Straighten through the leg, forward fold, modified pyramid pose, three full slow breaths. Breathe into that whole back side of the body. Bend back into that left leg, lift the gaze, take two breaths. Feel that stretch at top of that left, right thigh into that psoas muscle. Bring those palms to the mat, step it back, close to your vinyasa. Raise deep full inhales. Let go to the exhale. Your next inhale takes the gaze forward. Bottom of the exhale, step, jump, float it forward. Forward fold. Grab opposite elbows, head hangs heavy. Just breathe here, tuck the chin in. Halfway lift to lengthen, lean forward, gaze forward. Make sure those feet are hips width distance. Again, that is two fist width. Baddha Hastasana, gorilla pose, palms underneath the feet. Big toes to meet the wrist creases. Inhale to lengthen, exhale to fold. Tuck the chin in. Think about extending crown of the head, top of the feet. As you roll more weight forward onto the ball mounds of the feet. Eventually those hips sat directly on top of the knees, on top of the ankles. Breathe deeply here. And slowly release, halfway lift to lengthen. Palms to the mat, step it back, flow through your vinyasa. Close the eyes. I tell you what, you know, Arizona is not exactly my choice, my first choice, not my choice, I'm not being captured and kidnapped here, my first choice of a place to live. But I am inside, I do not have the AC on, and I am sweating. And so if you're going to be quarantined doing yoga at home, this is not a bad place to be, let me tell you. Take another nice deep full inhale. Let it go through the exhale. Inhale the right leg lifts. Exhale, step it through. Open up, warrior two. Find that alignment, find that strength through the stance. Legs are nice and strong. Left leg is nice and long, ground down outside of that back foot. Reach those arms up overhead. Take a bend into that left arm, right hand. But reach and grab that left elbow. Press the back of the head there into that crease there. And always stay here, perfect place to stay. You want full cow face. That right arm goes behind the back. Maybe those palms will clasp behind. Close the eyes. Maintain the integrity of the lunge on that right leg. Hardest thing here. We immediately want to kind of step out of it. Cultivate that strength. Cultivate some breath. Take another full inhale. Exhale, release those arms nice and long, nice and strong. Skandhasana into that left leg. One or both hands down at center. Flex through those right toes. Draw the shoulders down the back. Pivot yourself through those left toes. Plant through that right palm, roll those twist. Take that gaze up, twist the upper body back. We'll pivot all about 10 toes over there towards the left. A little fallen warrior. That left arm reaches behind you. Extend the hips towards the neck. Reach that left arm bicep by the ear. Lift the hips up. Lower the hips. Lower that arm. Reach it up. Stretch it up. Lower the hips. Lower that arm. Reach it up. Stretch it up. Pause. Hold here. Keep that left arm reaching. Affirm that right palm to the mat. Step the left foot behind you. Wide open. Right leg stays straight. High the ball up to that left foot. Push the hips up. Nice and slow, mindfully. Left knee in towards the chest. Pause, hold here. Step it forward. Slide yourself through center. Forward fold. Halfway lift to lengthen. Keep that flat back. Left arm reaches up. Take the gaze up. Twist the upper body back. Stay here. Half line or full body. Half line. Left arm reaches behind the back. Reach to the inside of that right hip. Hip stay square. So you're not reaching it, leaning it forward. You want a full bind. Right arm reaches underneath the leg, maybe those hands will clasp behind. It should be there at that crease where that hip and the glute meet. And then twist a little bit deeper. You have a full bind, you want to invert a paradise. Step that left foot closer to the right. Mount through all four corners of the left foot, slow inhale to rise. Find yourself fully standing first. Whew. Get the shoulders in the same line. Let's bring that right shoulder in line with the left. Maybe start to straighten that right leg. You're in root of paradise. Come down nice and slow. You're in that twist. I'm going to bring those fingertips under the shoulders. Lengthen the forward gaze forward. Pivot yourself towards those right toes. Left knee comes to the mat. And open up through the hips. So pivot that pinky edge side to the mat so that the sole of the foot is facing out. Right hand comes to that inner thigh, and you open up here. It's a wonderful place to sit. You want a little quad stretch. Take a bend into the left leg, reach back right hand, grab that third ankle, and continuously pull that heel in. If you're trying to reach for that ankle and you're kind of rounding forward, just energetically keep that left foot a little bit closer. You need a little bit more. Come down onto that left forearm. Maybe grab that right big toe. We're holding onto that foot, that slingshotting, slowly release it. Come back through center, plant through those palms, step it back, pull through your vinyasa. Nice full inhale. Nice long exhale. Now that left leg up. Seven. through. Warrior two. Find that alignment, find the breath here. Draw the shoulders down the back. Fingers are spread nice and wide. Maybe close the eyes. Really feel that length through the right leg. You reach those arms up overhead. Sometimes you take a bend into that right leg and left hand. Just kind of use that leverage eraser to open up through the shoulders. Press the back of the head there into that crease. Perfect place to stay. That full cow face. Left arm reaches behind the back. The palm will face out. Whatever feels better to you, close the eyes. Maintain the integrity of the lunge on that left leg. Soften the breath. Come back to your intention. One more full inhale. As you let go on the exhale, reach those arms up nice and long, nice and strong. Skandhasana, bend into that right leg. Left leg is nice and long, toes are flexed. One or both hands to heart center, pause. Pivot yourself towards those right toes, low lunge twist. Reach that right arm up towards the ceiling. Make sure right toes and knees are straight ahead. And pivot all 10 toes facing that right. Lower that hips. Extend right arm behind you. Lift the hips, reach and stretch. Lower. Lift it up, reach and stretch. As you lower. Reach and stretch, keep the hips nice and high. Reach that right arm a little bit more forward, nice and slow, with control. Right foot steps behind you, finding that wild thing. Left leg stays straight. High the ball onto that right foot, push the hips up. Everyone's favorite transition. Right knee comes in towards the chest, pause, hold here. Step it forward, step it through, forward fold. Halfway lift. As you lengthen, lean forward, gaze forward, keep the flat back. Right arm will reach up, take the gaze up. Half bind, full bind, whatever suits you on this side. Yeah, that full bind, you want to look into that bird of paradise. Again, stepping that right foot closer to the left. Mount through all four corners of that right foot. Inhale to rise. If you're working your twist, whatever level of twist you're at, I think eventually that torso is going to face the ceiling. Finding breath here, whether you're in that forward fold or in bird of paradise, can you breathe into the hamstrings? Take one more breath. Okay, birds come down nice and slow. And then release those fingertips under the shoulders, lengthen through the spine. Pivot yourself towards those left toes. Bring that right knee to the mat. Pivot to the outside of that left foot. Just start by opening up through the hip. Just a slight twist through the spine. That left hand goes to the inner thigh. Feels good. Run a little quad stretch. Take a bend into that right. Reach back to that left hand again, pulling that heel in towards the glute. If you can't reach for whatever reason, just energetically kick that heel towards the glute. Feeling extra bendy, you want a little bit more, come onto that right forearm. Maybe your right hand can grab that left big toe. Again, if that left shoulder is rounding forward or leaning forward, you want to get that twist open, so maybe come back up onto that palm. Two full rich cycles of breath. You're holding onto that foot with that slingshot, slowly release. Plant through those palms, come back through center. And you're firm through that left foot, this time step right foot next to left. Forward fold. That opposite elbow's head hangs heavy. Breathe here, let it go. Relax the jaw. Soften through the face. Halfway lift to lengthen. Bring those big toes to touch. Come nice and high in the ball. Onto the feet. Take a bend into the knees. Chin tucks into the chest. Forehead to knees. Just pause. Hold here. And come onto those knees. Sit back onto the heels. And bring those hands to the thighs. Close the eyes. Take a nice deep full inhale through the nose, fill the lungs up. Exhale, open mouth, let it go. Take another full inhale through the nose, fill the lungs up. Exhale, open mouth. Take one more just like that. Seal the lips. Come back to that strong ujjayi breath. Really collect the breath. Quiet the mind. So we're going to have a little fun here. We went into some shavasana headstand yesterday. We'll do the same. So if you know where you're going, go for it. You want to move that mat against a wall, go for it. You have that space. You want to cue into it. So there's always just, even if you're not there yet because you're freaking out, because you're scared, because you don't think you're strong enough, like, fine. It is step by step, just like any other posture. Step one is finding that alignment so those elbows aren't wide. They're about shoulder width distance, maybe even closer, interlace your grip. Bring those forearms to the mat. Bring the crown of the head, so it's not the forehead, it's not that crease there, the hairline, it's the crown of the head to the mat. And just lift the hips. Maybe this is where you're at today. Perfect place to stay. Just notice you're not like, whatever that thing is. Really press the forearms into the mat. Really engage through the legs. Slowly start to walk those toes a little bit further, a little bit closer to those elbows. Maybe that's where you're at. Stay there. You can kind of just start to pulse even. Start to notice how those hips come over the shoulders. Once you get those hips over the shoulders, use breath. Try not to kick up. Really more safety here than anything. Find yourself all the way up. You find yourself all the way up. Really firm forearms into the mat. Engage the legs. Find some breath here wherever you're at. Wherever you're working. Do it with strength. Do it with integrity. So often we focus so much on finding that end goal, finding that headstand. We forget about all of the processes, everything that it takes to get there. Don't worry about where you're at, where you think you should be at. Just be there. Whenever you've had enough, you will meet in embryo pose. That's with the knees together, the feet together. Forward to the mat, the arms will reach behind you, palms face up. Take a few moments here. Reconnect. Let it go. Come in here and start getting into your head, talking to yourself. Release that. Come back to breath. And you start to take a count in your head. Those inhales to 3, 4, maybe even 5. Take that count in your head. On your exhales, 4, 5, maybe even 6. It gives your mind something to focus on. Take 2 full rich breaths. Start to reach and extend those fingertips forward. Widen those knees. Find yourself in child's pose, more traditional here, or breath. Bring those palms to the mat. Slide the torso forward, finding that king cobra we did at the beginning of class. Those big toes to touch. Press the earth with the palms. Drop the head. Draw the hips towards the mat. Tuck round it back. Child's pose. Slide it forward. Round it back. One more, just find yourself here in this nice king cobra. Press the earth leg, start to go a little bit deeper. Extend those legs out nice and long. Take a full exhale, release. Use those hands as a pillow here. As deep full inhales. Nice long, full exhales. Find yourself in a little sphinx pose, shoulders under the elbows, forearms come to the mat. And track the left fingertips towards that right elbow. Take a bend into the right leg, reach back right hand. So you grab that foot, that ankle, get a little quad stretch in here. Notice you're not like hanging out here like the cool guy. Press that right left forearm firmly into the mat. And slowly release. So you'll switch sides. Right fingertips point towards the left elbow. Take a bend into that left leg. Reach back. Really breathe here. Take one more breath. Slowly release that. Come back to Sphinx pose. Slide that torso forward. Take the gaze down the bridge of the nose. Walk those hands a little bit closer in, press up, high over. Come through tabletop, push back and up, downward facing dog. Nice deep full inhales. Nice long, slow exhales. Inhale that right leg up. Bend the knees, stack the hip. Nice big hip roll and any additional movements that feel good. Perfect place to stay. You want to go a little more traditional into a wild thing. High in the ball arms of the left foot first. Pivot to the outside of the left foot. Left leg stays nice and straight. See if you can start by lifting right fingertips off the mat. Then step that right foot behind you. Push the hips up. Return back to three-legged dog. Right leg long behind you. Take a nice deep full inhale. Exhale, step it all the way through. Open yourself up, warrior two. Here for a breath. Straighten that front leg, reach the arms up, reach up, stretch up. Reach those arms behind you, find a humble warrior, get heels and hands tight together. Pivot right toes parallel to the left. Inhale to lengthen, exhale to fold. Just really let it go. Breathe into those shoulders. So whether you're working kind of that headstand variation there, you're working into it. Should feel pretty good here through the shoulders. Release that grip. Fingertips under the shoulders as you lengthen. Just pivot yourself towards those right toes. Come behind the ball and onto that back foot. Keep that left knee off the mat. Just track that right foot all the way over to the left. Kind of bring knee to the mat as if you're going into half pigeon, but keep that left leg lifted. Lengthen through the spine. We're going to tap through those fingers. Feel that stretch into that psoas muscle. Take another breath. And slowly release that left knee to the mat. Reach those arms forward, stretch it forward, half pigeon. So if you're feeling any strain here into that right knee, then roll onto the back of your thread the needle. Roll onto that right hip and just take a more generous bend into the left as you forward fold. Remembering, let me go, achy sensations, those are normal, expected. Anything else, that pinching, you know, pain, gone too far. One more breath here. Release, confirm through the palms, curl those back toes, step it back, flow through your vinyasa, or just meeting down up, whatever serves you. Inhale that left leg. Bend the knees, stack the hip, nice big hip roll again. Any additional movements that feel good. Do what works for you. If you are moving into wild thing, practice with that integrity, with intention. High in the ball mounds of that right foot. Keep the right leg straight as you pivot to the outside of that right foot. Can you start by lifting those left fingertips off the mat, using that core strength. Those left toes come behind you, push the hips up. Knees back to three-legged dog, wherever you're at. Left hip rolls down towards the mat, full inhale. Exhale, step it through. Open up, warrior two. Find your breath here. Straighten the leg, reach the arms up, reach up, stretch up. Reach those arms behind the back, find that humble warrior grip. Goofy thumb on bottom and thumb on top. Pivot left toes to right. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, fold. Really let it go. Breathe into the shoulders, wherever else it might feel tight. Should feel nice release there through the hamstrings. Slowly release fingertips under the shoulders. Lengthen through the spine. Pivot towards those left toes. Charge through that right leg high in the ball onto that right foot. And then toe heel that left foot over. Knee to the mat as if you're going into that half pigeon, keeping that right leg charged, tap through the fingertips. Take a few long breaths here. Relax the jaw. Move the tongue from the roof of the mouth, you can always move it around the mouth a few times. Just let it settle in that space, top, bottom, teeth. Take one breath. release that right knee to the mat. You can untuck those back toes. Inhale gives you that length. Exhale allows you to reach and stretch it forward. Pigeon. As you find some nice deep breath here, check in with those thoughts. Where are you at? You're heading here towards the end of the practice. So already start by really clearing any of that last little bit of gunk out. Releasing any energy that won't serve you, maybe releasing it through the hips. Take a nice deep full in. Nice long, slow exhale. Release, press up through the palms, just roll around at that left hip and slide that right leg forward. Bring the soles of the feet together. Butterfly pose. So yogi's choice. The soles of the feet together. You want to work more into the hamstrings. The heels are further away from the groin. You want to work through those inner thighs. Draw the heels closer in. Either variation, start by opening up those feet like a book. Eventually, soles of the feet will be up towards the ceiling. As you inhale, lengthen. Exhale, hinge. Stretch it forward. So rather than tucking the chin into the chest, I'm going to take the gaze a little bit more forward. It will keep the spine long. Wherever you're feeling this the most. And breathe some more energy, new breath there. Close the eyes. One more full inhale. Long exhale. Take the inhale, rise up, bring the soles of the feet to the outer edges of the mat. Just kind of sway them side to side. Neutral wipe those legs a few times. Give a little release here. We'll bring the legs together, feet together, feet are flat. So if you're pretty tight in the hamstrings, you can take a block of those books or whatever you're using. You can sit on that. It makes this little forward fold a little more accessible. If you're pretty flexible here in the hamstrings, you can take that block or book or whatever you're using and put them at the soles of the feet, reaching those fingertips forward. Either way, legs are engaged. Reach the arms up, reach up, stretch up. Hinge at the waist as you lead with the chest. Ashimottanasana, a nice seated forward fold. And breathing not just into the hamstrings, but all of those muscles either side of the vertebrae. Nice full stretch to the whole back side of the body. As you inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold, stretch a little bit deeper, three full breaths. Inhale to rise. Keep those legs forward. Reach the arms forward. Slide yourself to the middle of the mat if you're not there already. Full inhale. Exhale, tuck around. Curl. Bring yourself all the way down. The lower you go, the slower you go. Keep that core engaged. Last little bit of strength. So you find yourself all the way down. Happy baby. Arms to the inside of the legs. Grab the outsides of the feet or the big toes. And draw the tailbone to the mat. You can keep the tailbone to the mat. You can take that sway side to side. Probably have a lot of room. Hopefully you have a lot of room. Maybe stretch into those hamstrings. Try to bring a big toe to either side of the head. Still keeping that tailbone down to the mat. I think the place that feels good. Letting all the hard work is over. And bring those knees in towards the body. Tuck the chin into the chest. Forehead into the knees. Give yourself a little bit of a squeeze, that last bit of love. Lay it out now. And long. Find your shape. What serves you for your savasana. Legs can go nice and long and wide. Arms can go wide. Close the eyes. Take a nice deep full inhale through the nose. Fill the ones up. Exhale, open mouth, let it go. Allow everything to soften here. Nothing else to do here. Just be with yourself. Just breathe with yourself. Any thoughts that come to pass, acknowledge them. Just don't hold on to them. Let them just pass from ear to ear. Savasana sometimes seems like a waste of time just laying here after all. Notice the more you can lay here, those layers of resistance, when they start to fade away, the posture becomes easier, it becomes better. Ultimately, that space of quiet, that calm, that same groundedness you had at the beginning of your practice becomes even deeper here. So take the time to enjoy yourself here. Always an honor. Thank you for allowing me in your home, in your space. Namaste.